If President Barack Obama invited you to Capitol Hill, would you go? Well, Australia's most famous neurosurgeon would and will next Friday. He's been asked to deliver his 10-year plan to cure brain cancer, and that'll be delivered to the US Congress. He sat down today with Danielle Isdale to chat about it.
He saves a life most weeks, but now Charlie Teo has an opportunity to save millions if his address to US Congress pays off.
Once I strike that chord, get their attention, I want to impress upon them the need to fund research.
He'll deliver his 10-year plan to cure brain cancer in Washington next Friday as part of President Obama's initiative to map the human brain. He owes it, he says, to sufferers.
The lives I've saved gives you the pleasure and the motivation that you're doing something good. The lives you've lost gives you that terrible feeling that you've failed your patient.
Chris O'Brien, a fellow surgeon and his patient, died of brain cancer in 2009. His vision still inspires Professor Teo.
Innovation, discovery, absolute excellence was the name of the game for both of them.
If I could sort of get half the respect that Chris O'Brien got from his overseas colleagues, then I think I've achieved something.
A cure would cost billions of dollars in research and the collaboration of the world's best experts.
Until we find that cure, it's not over.
Cancer sufferer Glenn McDonald believes it can be done. His life depends on it.
He's having a go. Someone needs to step up to the plate. It's Charlie Teo.
When do you think you'll be satisfied? What is that goal that you are striving to achieve?
A lot of people ask me that. It's the same answer every time. I will not be happy, I will not rest until I find a cure for brain cancer.
Danielle Isdale, 10 News.